Hey there, I'm Kathleen.
I'm Ilya.
And we are Freedom Champagne. And what we are discussing today is giving you tips, real practicality, advice on how you can also travel full-time in an RV, if your heart desires so. We're 32 years old together. Everybody else where we are in Florida right now is triple our age. They probably worked their whole life. They look at us like, who are these people, you know? And it's a surreal feeling to know that we're able to do this, that we're a snowbird.
Yeah.
Because of everything that we've done in our life that led us up to here, to be able to travel full time in an RV with our German Shepherd and our 2-year-old daughter.
It didn't happen overnight, but we will share 5 tips with you that something that we did to help us to achieve that lifestyle.
And so now we're going to be traveling for 6 months in our Class A motorhome. Because of things that we did over the years, it doesn't happen overnight. It is a long-term progress, but if it is something that you really want to do, you can set up your life, you can optimize your lifestyle to achieve full-time travel. So let's jump into our 5 tips. We are a family of 4 who have prioritized adventure, freedom, and happiness over the mundane 9-to-5 grind. We've sold our cars, rented out our home on Airbnb, and bought a Class A motorhome to travel throughout Canada and the United States. Woo-hoo! With our 21-month-old Lucia and 5-year-old German Shepherd Benny, we've chosen the unconventional route of travel. We know that big magic happens outside of our comfort zones. Even though it's scary to leave the comforts of home behind, we know that as long as we have each other, home is where we are. We are location-independent freedom chasers who have built successful businesses and teams that have allowed us to travel full-time. Subscribe to our channel for raw, inspiring episodes. Travel along with us as we discover national parks, campgrounds, mouth-watering restaurants, North American cities, and more as a full-time travel So number 1 we would suggest is actually buy property. Take the time to invest into owning your own property so that you're building equity and you have control over that space if you do want to leave.
We bought our house 5 years ago, and not knowing that the prices will go down, we did not expect any of this to happen, but the best
prices
time
to go up.
Yeah. But the best time to buy a house is like yesterday, right? So every time you'll own a property, eventually it will go up in value, which will allow you financially like to refinance or have equity, which will down the line will help you establish your goals.
And so we have to say that we did not use the equity in our home to buy the Class A motorhome. But as you will see in number 3, we are using our home as an Airbnb. We've decided to be Airbnb hosts with our home. So that's kind of why it's so important to own your own property, to build that equity, and to have control over your asset. Versus renting, you're just kind of throwing money out the window, as now we've kind of like set up ourselves to be able to do what we're doing because we bought that property 5 years ago. And so what we bought was, it's not a huge elaborate home either. It's a townhome in the capital of Ottawa. So a lot of people are coming in. We've had a lot of bookings so far. And so we'll get to that in tip number 3. So number 2 on our list of things that you can do to optimize your life for full-time travel is invest early. Invest as early as possible.
Buy your own stocks. Don't invest with the banks, or don't give your money to somebody to manage. do your own research, do your own due diligence, and buy those stocks.
For example, we use Wealthsimple to buy stocks.
On a weekly or a monthly basis or a bi-weekly basis, stocks that you believe in, for example, Google or Tesla, that you know that they're not going to go anywhere, put something there. Put something there as often as you can. It will increase in value, and that's basically your retirement money.
Yeah, plus it's also nice to know that you have a cushion if you need money. Yeah.
If anything happens, you know that you have it there.
We started saving. I started investing at least like six, seven years ago. And now that the market is down, I'm actually investing more and more. So it's just smart to get smart about money so that you can start to think about full-time travel without the worrisome of living paycheck to paycheck, for example. So start investing as early as possible. Number three is become an Airbnb host. So this is something that I wanted to do with our home for so long, for a very long time, for years and years and years. But my husband here didn't want that.
Nope. It was hard for me to give away basically our home base, all of our stuff, all of our possessions, you know, just to let other people, you know, use it. It was kind of weird feeling for me.
You have to get comfortable with the uncomfortable, right? As like, yes, it's our stuff, but at the end of it, it's just stuff, you know? And we've taken out our prized possession, things that we don't want to get broken, but the reward outweighs the risk in the sense that now that we're on the road, there are people in our place that are covering the costs and even making us a little bit more.
Yeah, and that's the reason why we decided to go with Airbnb and not a long-term renter, because we wanted, first of all, the ability to go back anytime what we want. If something goes wrong, we know that we have our house and we don't need to break any contracts, and that would be much, much easier. And also, Airbnb, you don't have to take all of your stuff out, like your couch, your TV. Yeah.
You don't have to pay for storage somewhere. Yeah. Like, it's, you need the stuff to be there, and so do use your guests.
Logistically, so it's much, much easier.
Yeah, it's a win-win. And so,
and the profits, I think, are much, much higher than, that's another thing, the profits with Airbnb would be much higher than any monthly renter.
Yeah. But we have to say, like, that's what our whole channel is about, right? Freedom Champagne is, if you don't take risks, you don't get to drink champagne. So I will be eventually launching a video about our first guest. It was a nightmare. It was a really, really bad nightmare. But in the end of it, we made money, and it made us a thicker skin, and we trust our property manager a lot better. So there will be hiccups along the way. It's not a perfect journey, but all of that is just expanding in our own selves as well. As like before, he didn't want us to Airbnb our house. And now I'm thinking that it's going to be an investment property forever, and we're just going to buy another property to eventually live in or to rent out. Who knows? We don't really know, but we have options. And that's the fun part about owning your own property.
Exactly.
You have the ability to be an Airbnb host if you so choose that journey. And that's a really good step in becoming a full-time travel family.
Exactly. It doesn't matter if you have to go, like, you don't have to go RVing for that matter, right? Like, if you want to decide that you want to go to Spain for 3 months, you know, like, you can rent your house, and you're, at least you don't have to worry about all of those house expenses like mortgage and bills. It's going to be paid, and you'll probably will get some also profit.
And you're helping people along the way too, right? Like the people that are staying in our house before, they were new permanent residents to Canada coming from Africa. Now it's another group of new permanent residents coming from Czech Republic with families. Like, our house has a crib in it. So it's like we're helping families who are coming to Ottawa have a home while we're not there, instead of it being empty. I wouldn't want to leave our house empty.
Yeah, especially in the winter.
Exactly. So think about becoming an Airbnb host. And I'll actually include a link that in the show notes, in the comments, that you can earn some money by becoming an Airbnb host. Number four is eliminate as much debt as possible. So for us to be able to come traveling full-time in a motorhome, we sold our cars. My husband loved his car.
Yeah, it was a nice 2021 Model Y.
Tesla
Model Y.
Custom wrapped.
Yes. I put crazy amount of kilometers. I would never, ever thought that I would sell this car. We wanted to tow it behind the RV, but logistically, again, it would be a nightmare to get another trailer, to worry about the car at the back. Like it was just not an easy, you know, going decision.
But at the beginning, he told me, like, I'm not selling my car. I am bringing the car with us. Like, he was like, I'm bringing it. So he was looking at paying, what, $5,000 to get a trailer to put the car on and tow it. So then it became this huge expense of the $5,000 trailer, the monthly payments that he was doing on the car.
Yeah.
Plus the extra gas mileage of towing the vehicle.
And not every place also will let you come with a trailer, and like it's, again, logistically, it would be just a nightmare. So
he ended up selling it.
Yeah, we looked at the option of selling the car, and the market was favorable for us, and we actually made money selling both of our cars. Not only we closed our debt, we actually had money left in our pocket.
So once he sold his car, I had a Nissan Qashqai manual that like had no power in it, right? Like it was like a second car. So the thought of that becoming our first car, we didn't like it. Like we were like, might as well sell it too. So he put my car online and a dealer bought it. Two dealers bought both cars.
Yeah.
And made a profit, and so we had no car.
Yeah, for a while we had no car, but
we still have no car.
We brought our bicycles, and now we use our bicycles everywhere. Biking. It's much more convenient, I find, just to drop it off the hitch and just go anywhere you want.
Like, yeah. Especially because we have a toddler, right? So, like, she's sleeping. It's the middle of the afternoon. She sleeps for 2 hours every day. So even if we had a car, it's not like we could just, like, go off and not be putting her to bed, right? So, like, it's for us, the bikes, yes, we can't, like, go super far and, like, we can explore where we are, which is even more important for the campsites that we choose so that there are some type of, like, activities, pool, beach.
Yeah, so we definitely look more at the campsite and we try to decide like which campsite we can go. But also we decided that if we go into a place that has a lot of attractions around it, we will just rent a car if we need it. You know, it's not the end of the world because to rent it for 3-4 days.
Yeah, because we don't have those monthly expenses of the insurance and the payments of both of our cars, which was excessive. So now, yes, we have a bus payment. That's it. We don't have excess payments and we have no toad.
Yep.
Maybe one day we traveled when she was older, we would probably tow a car.
Towing a car, but I would say we would need, like at this point, a different vehicle. It would have to be a diesel pusher, like a much bigger RV.
But that's for a whole, future. In the future, maybe we would do that. But for now, how we've set this up, it really works for our family. I'm super happy with having the bikes. Like, I just had to go to the store, just jump on my bike. Like, you feel a sense of freedom not having the cars. And you have a sense of, like, you're exploring, you're active, getting a workout. It's a different lifestyle. And that's really what we wanted.
Yeah, for sure.
So I'm proud of you for letting go of that car.
Yeah. We'll buy a new one when we come back.
We'll see. So number five on how you can afford to travel full-time is have a passive income or have the ability to work remotely. So the two of us, we're both self-employed. We both have businesses, separate businesses that allow us to work remotely while being paid. These are businesses that we started 4-3 years ago. It was, again, not something that happened overnight, but it's now it's given us this ability to work remotely from anywhere that we are, as long as we have a Wi-Fi connection.
Yeah, and it's also, it wasn't planned. Like, it wasn't planned that we will let it go. Like, I'm a true believer, I was a believer, that you need to be there to run your business, and it would not work without you. In some cases, it might be right, but I think every single business can be built eventually and transport it to a way of working off, like, outside of that, you know.
Like, in our case, we took years to hire the right people, to delegate the right responsibilities,
to train,
to trust,
and
to empower our employees. That has given us this ability. It didn't happen overnight.
No.
And it did take a lot of convincing, as I've always wanted, you know, I've always believed in businesses that you don't have to put so much in it, you know, like, I don't believe in working full time. I don't believe in stressing yourself out. I don't believe in harder. I believe in working smarter, especially in this day and age. There's so many people that you can hire and delegate tasks to. As long as you're able to bring in those leads, you're able to have a thriving business, you can be free.
I'm a believer that nobody will work as hard as you will work on your business, and nobody will care as much about your business as you are. But it's true in some, it's true, it's really true in some point, but is the change that has to happen in yourself that, yes, okay, nobody's gonna work as hard as I am working in my business, but people still want to work. People still, you know, they need to feed their family, and just the fact that we give that opportunity to provide employment for like 5, 6, 7 employees right now, that you know, that
plus my team, plus the people I hire,
you know, the full time,
and it's magical at the same time that you're able to create jobs, you're able to create growth, economic growth, prosperity,
and it can happen with any business. Like, it can be anything, you know.
Yeah, but anyway, like, there's, even if you don't want to be a business owner, there's so many jobs that can allow you to work remotely.
Yeah, so many.
Like, definitely. So there's no excuse, especially if you don't like your job and you're looking for something remotely so that you can travel. Do it. Take that leap of faith and try something new, as, like, your future self will thank you for it. All right, guys. So that was 5 tips of that things that you can do to optimize your life so that you can travel full time. It's not easy to navigate how to travel full time, how to be location independent, how to be a digital nomad. But where there's a will, there's a way, and you just have to really believe in yourself and have somebody to kind of, like, show you the way that it is possible.
Yeah, it's not always, you know, obvious what is the way, you know, or what are we doing. And until you know, dip your feet into water, you would not understand, like, you would not know what to do.
Yeah, but it takes that just, like, initial step, just taking that step. And, like, even, like, we bought the bus and didn't know for sure that we would sell the cars, like, all of those things kind of worked its way out because we put it out there that, like, we're doing this, we're leaving. And so a lot of sacrifices had to be had, but the ball rolled. And here we are now in Salt Springs, Florida. And you can be too. So thank you for watching. Follow Freedom Champagne on Instagram and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more full-time travel
tips and
digital nomad advice. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Follow us on Instagram, Freedom Champagne. We're here to help other people become digital nomads.
If you have any questions, just leave the comments or send us an email.
Yeah, please do. Leave, like, comments, questions leave it for us. We're here for it all. We're
here.
Yeah.